Everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be going over the new Salesforce User Experience Designer certification. So this is a new Salesforce certification as of spring 21, and I'm pretty excited about it. Before we get too far in the video, I would really appreciate it if you would like and subscribe. And I have a deal to make with you guys. If this video gets 50 likes, then I will take this certification. If it gets 100, then I will create a course on this certification. And if you want to go check out my other courses, they'll be linked down in the description below. All right, let's talk about the Certified User Experience Designer. So this exam is a 60 multiple choice, multiple select questions like all the other exams. You have 105 minutes or about an hour, 45 minutes to take and pass this exam. Passing score is 65%, and it is $200 plus the taxes. Retake is 100. And you can often find some coupon codes on AmpScript, which I will link down below. You can take it on site or online. I prefer online because I like to take it in my comfy clothes. And it's just your typical Salesforce exam for all of the things. So they do have a trail mix and a module for this. They do have practice questions for the exam within that trail mix, and there's a bunch of different things. Let's go ahead and actually get into the exam outline. So we have six different sections, and I would say two of them are about gathering, or maybe three of them are about gathering different requirements. So that's what I would say discovery is about. You want to research the different methods and be able to, based upon the business requirements, determine the research methodology and what design solution would work for this. You'll also want to gather requirements and understand what that does. If you're familiar with being a business analyst, this section will come really easy to you. And then also describe the key UX personas. So discovery is really a lot about talking to the user. What kinds of things is the user looking for? How can we best serve our user? And how best can we gather these requirements? And these are what I like to call the squishy skills. They're still really important, but they're more about talking it through and gathering great requirements. All right, then we go into UX fundamentals. So, given a scenario, identify which UX method should be used to define the user experience. Describe the impact of corporate branding and styling. So you can have the Salesforce org designed to be more like your corporate logo and other things. And then you can describe the key design principles that define the accessible and engaging experience. And describe mobile UX design fundamentals. So I think here is going to be a lot of mobile branding and maybe paths here as well. And then we have human-centered design at a 12%. So given a scenario, design how to incorporate human-centered design into a customer solution, and then explain the importance of an exclusive design. And then we have declarative design at 27%. So this is a huge section, and I believe this is the biggest section of the exam. Given a scenario, describe how core Salesforce objects function, how that can affect the user experience when to customize them. Given a scenario, describe the declarative features that improve information presentation, hierarchy, and architecture in static experiences. Given a scenario, describe declarative features that improve user efficiency. Describe and determine which global Salesforce configuration can be optimized for user flow. Given a scenario, determine options for users' access for onboarding support and learning, and describe how to apply branding to a solution. All right, so that is a lot of words, and that is a lot of different things that are going to be covered. But I think what it really comes down is like page layouts, record types. You've got the different hierarchies and how you can see that based upon your security, branding. You've got paths, guided things, and possibly flows and screen flows that will be on there. So lots of fun stuff that kind of touches all the different areas. You've got automation here. You've got objects, standard custom objects. You've got all these different scenarios, but really how the UI is customized based upon that. And then you come into testing. I think this will deal with a lot of UAT or user acceptance testing, because you'll want to be designing this with the user in mind. And then you have the different techniques that you can use for designing. And then evaluate how to manage design changes. Right, and the final section is about the Lightning Design System, or the Salesforce Lightning Design System, SLDS, at 21%. So you want to describe the SLDS. And then, given a scenario, determine the out-of-box solution and configuration consistent with the look and feel of Salesforce, the Lightning experience. Given a scenario, you want to utilize the SDLS and create a new customized component functionality. So basically what the SDLS is, the custom styling that you can use for creating custom components and pages within Lightning. So this is a little bit more code heavy, but you don't need to pass this section, the code heavy section, to pass the exam. However, it would be really, really helpful if you were familiar with it. All right, and that is the overview of it. I would really check out the module that they have. It is linked here somewhere. Got the module and the UI credential. So it kind of just goes through all the different things that you would want to be familiar with, and different documentation that Salesforce has put out about this specific exam topic. So anyways, thank you for joining me for this video. Again, I will take it if we have 50 likes on this video, and if 100, I will create a Salesforce course on this exam. So thank you for joining me. I will catch you guys in the next one.